Hey, want to know how to create a design poster in a linear and geometric style and animate it? Well, here we go. We'll start by creating our main element in After Effects. We'll start by opening After Effects and working with a square workspace. We will create a new composition in the format 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels on a black background. Once on our composition, we will add a black solid and in effects and predefined parameters, add a turbulence noise effect. We will change its fractal type to dynamic. Then its noise type to linear blur. We will change its scale in transformation so that the noise is stretched in length by modifying its scale, and we will increase its contrast. Then we will transform this layer into a circle. To do this, we will add an effect called polar coordinates. We will set the interpolation to 100% and then set the type of convection to rect polar. That's it, we've created a circle with our effect. From here, we will create a new layer which will be an effect layer. We are going to apply the threshold effect to it, which will allow us to reduce our visual to only two colors. From here, we will make our shape more complex. To do this, we'll add a new solid and apply the circle effect to it. We'll set its color to black. With radius, we will enlarge it, and with progressive contour, we will enlarge our circle in a more diffuse way. We'll copy and paste our first solid and play with the previous parameters. In a type of fractal, we will choose turbulent smooth and give it the transfer mode alpha model, which will make it transparent. Then set its progressive contour to make it opaque. This will allow us to add details to the visual. Now we'll move on to the animation of our visual. I'm going to set my timeline to 20 seconds. Then we're going to start animating our visual to see how it looks. I'm going to zero in on my timeline. On my layer in the effect option, turbulence noise and evolution, click on the little stopwatch to add a keyframe at 0. I want to move to 10 seconds on my timeline and set the evolution to 2. We will move to 20 seconds on our timeline and set the evolution to 0. This will allow us to create a loop, always on the same layer. In transformation, we will activate the rotation. We go directly to 20 seconds. Add the value 1, which will make it make a complete turn. We will repeat the operation with our second layer. Here, we can see that everything comes to life little by little. For effect, as if it were an eye, an iris that expands. With the third layer, the one with the circle effect, we'll play the radius of the circle effect. We'll round the value to 200. And then we'll go back to 10 seconds to increase our value to 600. Then at 20 seconds, we'll set the value back to 200. This will allow us to have this eye effect that will grow and shrink. If we want to add more details or complexity to our visual, we can simply duplicate our layer and change its fractal type. Here in string, that we can rearrange as we wish. And here we have animated our visual with this dilation effect in the center. From here we will come to position where the visual seems interesting. Then in a composition, save the image as. We will save our composition on a PSD. And here is our first step. We will be able to pass on Photoshop to be able to create the continuation of our design. Once opened Photoshop, we will open our new composition that we will import on a rectangular format of type poster. I'm going to place my composition, and with select and color range, I'm going to select the white color and apply a mask to it, which will allow me to quickly change my shape. Then I will import a silhouette in the center to give a drop effect and a main element to our visual. We will focus on the geometric side of the poster, and for this, we will work with linear shapes. With the ellipse tool and an outline, we will create a circle around my visual. We can simply duplicate our ellipse to add new ones around our visual. Then we will create one with a white background and apply a blur effect in filter and Gaussian blur. Then we will add an effect by going to filters and filter gallery. we will add several filters. The first filter, reticulation, which will generate noise on top. Then a halftone pattern that we will put in line. We will add an effect, town edge, which will come to degrade it. Then we validate. I will group these layers to better align them. We will add an effect layer called threshold. We will continue to add details to our visual. I'm going to import a handmade vector shape that I'll drag underneath my layer and create a symmetry effect. Then I will simply duplicate my layers and play with their sizes. I will compose my visual by importing linear shapes from Illustrator or by creating shapes directly with the Shapes tool in Photoshop. Once we have our main visual, we can focus on the composition of our poster. For this, we will add a title and two or three graphic elements. I import directly a typography that I have distorted that will serve as a title. We will put a white line effect on it. To do this, I will double-click on it. Open the Layer Style panel, add stroke at 2 pixels and reduce its background to 0. Below, we will add a typography and add a thickness. Then simply with a left-click control on our typography at the top, then with a right-click. Select inverse. We are going to create a group and create him a mask with our selection. Then we will drag our typography inside this group. And here we have masked our typography for our title. I'm going to create a border for our poster simply with the rectangle tool that we will center. To create several border effects, I will duplicate this rectangle and play with the rounding of its corners. We will add a rounding to 300 pixels, and do the same with a rounding to 150 pixels. I'm going to import some text and some graphic elements to my composition. We will move on to the texture and color part. For this, we will create a layer of effects, gradient map. We will add a blue and a golden yellow in the background. This will allow us to redefine the colors of the layers below by the selected colors. To add a little texture to our poster and make it look a little paper and grainy, I'm going to import a texture that I made myself, which is a tracing paper texture that I scanned. Once it is placed, we will change its blending mode and choose overlay. Then we will duplicate it and apply the blending mode, color dodge. We can see when this has created a grainy texture directly on our visual and a bit of a glittery effect, as if the visual was golden. Once I'm happy with my visual, I'm going to organize my layers so I can find my way around in After Effects. We need to have all our layers in order, and all the layers we want to move must be well separated from each other. The rest we can simply pixelate or transform them into dynamic objects. In After Effects, we go in Import, then we are going to select our file. We must be careful to choose Import under Composition and Editable Layer Style. Otherwise, we will not be able to modify all the layers. Once in our composition, we can see that some effects are not necessarily taken into account in After Effects. To recreate our Gradient Map layer, we will create a new effects layer and look for the effect called Hue. Then we will get the same color values as the one chosen in Photoshop. With a simple copy and paste, I will redefine my color codes. As for our texture, we just have to make them visible and drag our tint effect layer underneath. Now that we have found our visual, we will move on to the animation part. We will find our layer that we created at the very beginning. Hide it and import our animated composition from the beginning of the video. We are going to put back our timeline to 20 seconds because we have created an animation that lasts 20 seconds. we can see that the animation works well in our poster. We will animate our character, so we'll click on our slap and in Transformers, we'll create keyframes and play with its position, its scale and its rotation. We'll move on to animating our circles that are around our main visual. It's all about these layers. So, as I want it to be at the same position and rotate directly from the center of my visual, I'm going to select all my ellipses. I'm going to open their transformations and I'm going to move their anchor point to the center of our visual. Then I'll move them up using position. We can check if they are centered by moving their rotation. If it's good, we'll create a keyframe at 0 seconds on our timeline. Then we'll go to 20 seconds. We will select only the small ellipses and give them a rotation of 3 turns. For the middle ellipses, we'll set the value 2 so that they only make 2 turns. And for the outer ones, we will set the value 1 so that they make only 1 turn in 20 seconds. We can reset to the beginning and launch the animation. And that's it. You know how to animate and create this kind of visual with Photoshop and After Effects. All you have to do is export it and you're done. Leave me a like if you liked this tutorial and subscribe so you don't miss my next creations. If you like this visual, it is available on my Redbubble store. The link in the description. Keep on creating and see you next time.